We've recently discovered the oldest specimen yet of mosquito encased in amber from the early Cretaceous. Can we do a Jurassic Park? Does it contain dinosaur DNA? Well, either way, it may contain science. In Michael Crichton's 1990 novel, scientists were able to extract ancient DNA from mosquitoes encased in amber and use it to recreate dinosaurs. Now, the recreate part is still extremely sci-fi. Even now, we have no way of making a full-on vertebrate from DNA alone. 2019 saw the first total synthesis of a microbe with a recoded genome, and that was introducing small segments of synthesized DNA to existing microbes to hot swap with their own code. And the difference between that and making a dinosaur is the difference between a lightning bug and lightning. But a funny thing happened after the publication of Jurassic Park. Even though we're nowhere close to the ultimate goal of Jurassic Park's premise, making a whole dinosaur with some frog bits, within a few years, scientists started to report that they could maybe do the mosquito in amber part. In the early 1990s, around the time of the book's release, multiple studies reported successful DNA extraction of very ancient DNA from things like resin. Unfortunately, we were never able to replicate those early attempts, nor even authenticate they were really ancient DNA and not the product of contamination. But it's 2024 now, so when your humble correspondent heard that we'd gotten dinosaur-era mosquitoes in amber, naturally I wanted to know. Has science advanced enough? Can life finally find a way? Short answer? Life's gonna be on hold for a while there, and it's to do with DNA itself. See, in some ways, DNA is a shockingly stable molecule when you think about all the things we do to it in the lab and all the places we can find samples, but DNA isn't indestructible. Far from it. Hit it with some radiation? Tch! DNA strand breaks everywhere! Hydrolytic processes? Yeah. That DNA will break and the store will not accept it at returns, even with receipts. We have so many DNA repair mechanisms in our own bodies because DNA degrades all the time, even in our lifetimes. To get a sample from these mosquitoes in amber, we're talking about a timescale literally 2 million times our own operational longevity. DNA degradation is what made amber such an attractive preservation mechanism for sci-fi like Jurassic Park, and for those 90 scientists who really thought they'd made it work IRL. Amber has some nifty antimicrobial properties, and in general, it allows for a fair amount of dehydration to preserve tissue, kind of like mummification. Paleontologist bug researchers, like the ones who discovered our dinosaur-era mosquitoes, love resin-encased insects for this reason. You can learn a lot about the structure of a bug encased in amber when most of it stays intact. But maintaining tissue isn't the same as maintaining DNA. Most of your structural tissue has no DNA in it at all because the overwhelming majority of DNA is inside cells. Mineralized tissue like bone matrix or cross-linked collagen in your skin, cartilage, and extracellular matrix. Those key structural components are products produced by cells, but they aren't cells themselves. That's why you can get a specimen encased in amber with tissue that's structurally preserved, but it doesn't mean you're going to get intact DNA to do your Jurassic Park. Only in the past couple of years have we been able to verifiably extract any DNA from insects trapped in amber resin, and we're talking 2 to 6 year old samples, a far cry from those 90s era claims. And that's not even DNA from the blood of another species the insect has bitten. And so far, the record for oldest DNA we've ever successfully recovered and sequenced is 2 million years. look, which is unbelievably impressive. It's just still a long way from dinosaurs. We didn't actually get that super old DNA from amber, we got it from environmental DNA. Environmental DNA isn't extracted from an organism directly, but from what it leaves behind. You recover DNA from a t-shirt at the crime scene I definitely have an alibi for. Ah, that's an example of environmental DNA. In the case of our 2-million-year-old environmental DNA, that was found adhered to the surface of sediment in the Arctic, and the electrical charge of the minerals allowed the DNA to bind to it and slow its rate of degradation. Even so, this ancient sample was a big deal, in part because it pushed the limits of how long DNA could remain chemically intact. That's not necessarily a science will eventually be able to figure this out with better technology sort of limit. We can only recover DNA if DNA chemically exists to be recovered. All of which is to say, as far as can we do a Jurassic Park is concerned, the current status is 90s experiments didn't seem to hold up, we've only been able to get 6-year-old DNA out of insects and amber, and we're about 64 million years short of recovering any DNA from the dinosaur era, and we may never be able to. Dang it. If we can't make dinosaurs out of these mosquitoes and amber, what are they even good for anyway? Look, I feel you, but I promise, there's lots of cool science that doesn't lead to velociraptors running rampant around an amusement park. First off, this actually is valuable mosquito science. Molecular estimates pin the first mosquitoes arising in the Jurassic, but until now, we've only had hard proof of late Cretaceous at best. And there's a big difference between we think mosquitoes were around in the early Cretaceous, and hey, here's an actual specimen. Early Cretaceous versus late may seem like an incremental leap, but you gotta remember, the Cretaceous was 79 million years long, meaning beginning to the end of the Cretaceous was more time than the end of the Cretaceous until now. A 130 million year old mosquito discovery is a big deal, even if it just gives me one more reason, I would never want to get into a time machine that was dinosaur-era bound. But this finding also did more than push back the proof clock on my least favorite arthropods. It also proved that mosquitoes actually kind of suck less now than they did then. Or rather that fewer of them suck now than they did then. Unlike modern mosquitoes, where only fertilized females are gnarly little bloodsuckers, the specimens found in this sample show that male Cretaceous-era mosquitoes also want to suck your blood. Modern males get their energy from plant nectar, taking advantage of flowering plants that evolved and proliferated in, yep, the Cretaceous. The findings from these specimens may ultimately help us understand the evolutionary history of insects whose mouth parts developed for necks of nectar and nectarex. All of these mosquito sciences may be inadequate compensation for the idea that we may never actually recover dinosaur DNA from mosquitoes or anything else. But if we can't bring back the dinosaurs we lost, least we can do is appreciate the species that shared the Earth with them and still share the Earth with us now. Crocodilians, frogs, lobsters, crabs, even mammalian monotremes like platypuses. They're the history that survived, and it's all the more important to take care of their environments so we don't break their lucky streak. And if you're pining for our lost Struthia mimus, hey, can I interest you in some Struthiformis?